Good morning, everyone. This is Shyam, Assistant Professor, Civil Department in Chevrolet Engineering College. Subject Geotechnical Engineering 1, Unit 3, Permeability. Today we will discuss introduction of the permeability. So in soil mechanics and foundation engineering, you must know how much water is flowing through the soil in any time. This knowledge is required to the design earth dams. Determine the quantity of seepage under hydraulic structures and dewater before and during the construction of foundations. So soil permeability. If the permeability is defined as the capacity of soil to allow the water pass through it, that is quantity of falling per unit of the soil surface under a pressure of one unit hydraulic gradient. Mainly the soil capacity, how bearing the water passes through it, quantity of falling in its soil surface under pressure. Soil permeability in soils are permeable due to the existence of the interconnected voids through the with water flow from points of high energy to the points of low energy. Here we see the connected to the water flow points from high energy to the points to the low energy. Here soil is a datum line, and it is the total height of the total head impervious soil line. Here is the total head HB to the water tank. Here is total head is known as HA, small HA, and another total head is the small HB. And it is water tank is starting is an end point to be connected to the height is H equal to total head A minus total head B. It is the impervious soils in passes through the soil in process through the water. A soil is highly pervious when the water can flow through it easily. Gravels in gravels, particles are rounded particles and gaps is formed in the gravels. So easily soil in water flow in soil gravel. These gravels are flow through easily, can easily flow of the water. In a impervious soil, the permeability is very low and water cannot easily flow through it. This soils are clay soils. It is the stiff clay. Then soils in water is not flow easily, and rocks are impermeable. The study of the flow of water through the permeable soil media is important in soil mechanics. The importance of the permeability, the following applications illustrate the importance of the permeability in geotechnical design. The permeability influences the rate of settlement of a saturated soil under load. The design of earth dams is very much based upon the permeability of the soils used. The stability of slopes and retaining structures can be greatly affected by the permeability of the soils involved. Filters made of soils are designed based upon their permeability. Next topic on this, factors affecting the permeability of the soils. Mainly factors affecting the permeability of soils, there are different 10 types mainly. There are, first one is the particle size. Second one is the void ratio of soil. And third one is the properties of soil, pore fluid. And fourth one is the shape of particles. Fifth one is the structure of soil mass. And sixth one is the degree of saturation. And seventh one is the absorbed water. Next, eighth one is the entrapped air and organic impurities in water. Next, ninth one is the temperature. And the 10th one is the stratification of soils. So we go to the discusses factors affecting individually, one by one. So first one is the particle size. The permeability varies approximately as the square of grain size, depending upon the effective diameter of grain size. So grain size diameter is D10. It is depends upon the effective diameter of the grain size. This is the particle size. And next one is the void ratio. Increase in the void ratio increases the area available for the flow, hence permeability increase for the critical condition. So void ratio is increases then area available for flow, permeability increase the critical condition. Next one is the properties of the pore fluid. Pore fluids are the fluids that occupy pore spaces in soils or rock. Permeability is directly proportional to the unit weight of the pore fluid and inversely proportional to the viscosity of the pore fluid. So in these two conditions, one is the permeability is proportional to the unit weight of the pore fluid. And next one is the permeability inversely to the proportional to viscosity of pore fluid. Next one, shape of particles. Permeability is inversely proportional to the specific surface. For example, the angular soil have a more specific surface area compared to the round soil. Therefore, the soil with the angular particles is less permeable than the soil of rounded particles. So, and next one is the fifth one, structure of soil mass. For same void ratio, the permeability is more for flocculent structure as compared to the disponent structure. So, soil structure, it is a flocculent structure. And as well dispersed structure. And next one is the degree of saturation. The degree of saturation in the permeability of partially saturated soil is less than that the fully saturated soil. So it is the partially saturated in soils and air gaps. It is the less than a fully saturated of the soil. So in this partially saturated means air form and water and soil. In this fully saturated is water in and soil. So here air is less than soil is less than to the fully saturated soil means partial saturated to the less than permeability fully saturated soil. Next one is the absorbed water. Absorbed water means the thin microscopic film of water surrounding individual soil grains. This water is not free to move and hence reduces the effective pore space and this decreases coefficient of permeability. This is absorbed water and next entrapped air and organic impurities. In this organic impurities and entrapped air obstruct the flow and coefficient of permeability is reduced due to their presence. So in this soil particles, air or water, or next one is the temperature. As the viscosity of the pore fluid decreases with the temperature, and permeability increases with the temperature, as the unit weight of the pore fluid does not change much, the change in temperature. So in this temperature, pore fluid decreases, and permeability increases temperature. Similarly, the unit weight of pore fluid does not change in much with the change of temperature. And next one, last one, is the factor affecting permeability in soils. Stratification of soil. Stratified soils are those soils which are formed by the layer upon layer of the earth or dust deposited to the each other. If the flow is parallel to the layers of stratification, the permeability is maximum. While the flow is perpendicular to direction is occur, the permeability is minimum. So here in two condition, the flow of parallel of layers is stratification is permeability is maximum, perpendicular then minimum permeability. Next one, water flow. The water flow is divided into two categories. One is the laminar flow. Second one is the turbulent flow. So first one is the laminar flow. It is indicates that each water particle flows. It is follows defined path and never crosses the path of another particle. And turbulent flow is the indicates the random path of irregular and twisted movement. So see the figures in difference of the laminar flow and turbulent flow. In this flow, the path never crosses the another particles. Similarly, in turbulent flow, it is irregular and twisted movement of the flows. Next one is the hydraulic gradient. So water below GWT surface is usually flowing under hydraulic gradient. It is defined as the slope of the free water surface in the direction of the flow. Here see the length of the water bed in soil bed, and height is the one side water H1 and another side is the H2. So it is calculated another one side answer water head delta H that equal to H1 minus H2. In hydraulic gradient is expressed as I. So see soils A and B, direction of the flow. One side is the height is H1. And another side is water height H2 is the flow of water. So mean difference of the different height is delta H. This means head loss. L is the A point, B point distance. The hydraulic gradient is expressed to the I equal to delta H by L, where I equal to hydraulic gradient. And delta H equal to head loss, and L equal to distance between the points A and B. Next, Darcy's law. Henry Darcy, he was a hydraulic engineer. His law is the foundation stone for several fields in study. Darcy's law demonstrated experimentally that for laminar flow conditions in the saturated soil, the rate of flow or the discharge per unit time is proportional to the hydraulic gradient. In Darcy's law, stated that the flow of water through the porous media is directly proportional to the head loss and inversely proportional to the length of flow path. This may be as written as V equal to K into delta H by L or V equal to KI, where I equal VC, the I equal delta H by L. So where K is equal to permeability coefficient or hydraulic conductivity, and V is the discharge velocity or average velocity. Discharge velocity is the quantity of total water flowing in unit time Q through the unit cross-sectional area A of the soil at right angles of the direction of flow. So V equal to Q by A. It is the soil in direction of flow. Q is the unit time and A is the cross-sectional area. So then V equal to Q by A. V means velocity or average velocity. Next one, range of validity of Darcy's law. Darcy's type of flow is stable in characterized long as the four basic conditions of are always satisfied. The four conditions are, first one is the steady state is laminar flow. Next one, 100% saturation. And third condition is flow fulfilling consistency condition. Continuity conditions, and fourth one is the no volume changes occur during or as the result of flow. Next one is the seepage velocity. So area of solid specimens in this figure A and area of voids AV, area of soil solids AS. It is the flow of water Q in particles and length is 1 point to another point is L. The discharge of velocity based on the gross cross-sectional area of the soil. However, the actual velocity of the water, that is the seepage velocity through the void spaces, is greater than V. The relationship between the discharge velocity and seepage velocity. If the quantity of water flowing through the soil in unit time is Q, then Q equal to AV, that equal to AVVS. Here, VS is the seepage velocity and AV is the area of voids in the cross section in the specimen. C is the area of soil solids specimen AS and voids AV. Next one, an estimate of the actual velocity versus referred to as the seepage velocity can be made by considering the following equations. AV equal to AV into VS. So, and finally, V equal to velocity AV by A into VS. So AV by A is known, N into VS, V equal N into VS. Next one, range of validity of Darcy's law. Darcy's type of flow is stable in character as long as four basic conditions are always satisfied. We discuss four conditions. So first one is the steady state in laminar flow with no change in hydraulic gradient and 100% saturation and no air bubbles in soil voids, flow fulfilling continuity conditions and no volume changes occurs during the result of the flow. The total cross sectional area of the soil mass is considered. These are the different conditions. Next one is the hydraulic conductivity. Permeability is also known as hydraulic conductivity. Hydraulic conductivity marked as the K or K minus values is one of the principal and most important soil hydrology, means hydraulic characteristics parameter, and it is an important factor of water transport in the soil, and it is used in all equations for the groundwater, means subsurface water flow. The value of hydraulic conductivity varies widely for the different soils. The hydraulic conductivity of the unsaturated soils is lower and increases rapidly with the degree of saturation. So hydraulic conductivity, the coefficient of permeability also varies with the temperature. Upon with the very viscosity of the water depends. So here see the coefficient of permeability can also represented by the equation. At 20 degrees centigrade, K20 equal to NR by NI by N 20 degrees into KT. NI equal viscosity of water at a temperature T and 20 degrees. And value of hydraulic conductivity, this means soil type and K. And K is the hydraulic conductivity, or K minus. So typical value of saturated soils are given in the following table. One column is the soil type, another one is the hydraulic conductivity K, and units is centimeter per second. First soil is the clean gravel. It is 100 to 1 centimeter per second. And next soil is the coarse sand. It is 1 to 0.01 centimeter per seconds. Next soil is the fine sand, and the range is 0.01 to 0.001. And next one, silty clay. The range of silty clay 0.001 to 0.00001. And next one, clay less than 0.0001 range. So these are five types of soils and ranges also hydraulic conductivity. So five types of soils are: first one is the clean gravel, second one is the coarse sand and fine sand, silt clay, clay. Next one, empirical relations for K. Several empirical equations for the estimation K have been proposed in the past. Some of these are for uniform sand, K equal to CD D10 square. So it is the hydraulic gradient K, C into D10 square. Here only effective size, it is formed D10. So where C equal to a constant that varies from 1 to 1.5, and d10 is equal to effective size in mm. So effective size is d10, 10 mm. It is the effective size. So the empirical formula for estimation proposed to the relation for k, k equal to c into d 10 square. For dense or compacted sand and medium fine sand, k equal to 0.35 into d 15. D 15 square for compacted. K equal to 1.4 into E square into K. D means effective size of diameter, we know. And E and K, 0.85. So here K equal to hydraulic conductivity at the void ratio E. E is the void ratio at the hydraulic conductivity. And K 0.85 is the corresponding value at the void ratio of 0.85. So K is the hydraulic conductivity for compacted sand also, and D is the effective size 15 mm, and E is the void ratio, and K is the corresponding value of the void ratio of 0.85. We are giving any value of corresponding value of void ratio. Okay, it is the uniform sand, it is the compacted sand, and it is the fine sand. Here KC is the constant, varies from 1 to 1.5, and D is the effective size for D10, and compacted sand in D15 is the effective size also in mm, and medium fine sand also K is the hydraulic conductivity at void ratio E. So here E square. So in medium fine sand, see the K equal to 1.4 into E square, K suffix 0.85. Here E is the void ratio for the hydraulic conductivity at the E, and K 0.8 is the corresponding value of the void ratio. So these are the empirical relations for the K. There are three. One is the uniform sand, one is the compacted sand, and fine sand. These are different three relations for the K. This is the introduction of the permeability. Okay, thank you very much. Any doubt in the session?